guys, my name is Victoria Palov. I'm the Photoshop artist. Welcome to my studio. Today we will create image for our commercial advertisement in Adobe Photoshop CC. Of course, I will be using Adobe Photoshop CC, my Wacom tablet as usual, and 3D objects I downloaded from pixelsquid.com. So guys, let's start. As you can see, I have opened my Photoshop CC and I have created my simple document. You can create your document in any size you want to. Also, you can apply any color to your background layer. Everything is up to you. It's your creation. Here, I have opened my PixelSquid plugin with all 3D objects I downloaded from pixelsquid.com. To add your 3D object from a PixelSquid plugin into your open document, simply click on your 3D object and voila. In same place, in PixelSquid plugin, you can see this very big obvious window with a 3D can, 3D object on it. To rotate your 3D object, simply click on it and rotate it and voila. My 3D object updated in my document. I will move it. I will resize it, make it slightly bigger, just like this. I will move it, just like that. Maybe more. And voila, I will click OK to accept this layer. Now I have a few options. I can have my soda can in high or low resolution. Definitely I would like to have my soda in a high resolution, so I will switch from a low to high resolution. And definitely I would like to have my soda can with shadow, so I will not uncheck my shadow box, so it's on for now. And now time to bring my brand into my can, soda can. Here I have opened my Creative Cloud library with my text I would like to work with today. To add any asset from your Creative Cloud library into your open document, simply click on your asset and drag it into your document. I will resize it, I will make it smaller, just like that, and I will move it. Perfect. Just like that, I will click OK to accept this layer. I will merge my top two layers, so I will hide my background layer and I will click merge visible and voila, I will bring back my background layer. Now I will duplicate my soda can. For now I have two layers, one soda can layer and another layer is a simple background layer. I will rename my soda layer to first can, just like that, and I will duplicate my first can layer. Simply drag into new layer and voila, I will rename my new layer. Now you can see that this layer renamed to one can copy. I will double click on my layer's name and I will rename it to second can, just like that. And I will select my first can layer and I will move this layer, just like that. I will resize it, I will make it smaller, and I will reposition it. I will bring it on distance, just like that. Maybe I will increase size just slightly, just like that. Perfect. And I will click OK to accept all changes. I will move it down. Perfect, just like that. Now guys, I will duplicate my first can layer one more time. I will duplicate it and I will rename my new duplicated layer from one can copy layer to third can, just like that. And I will highlight my first can layer and I will move it, just like that. I'm sorry, see, I made mistake. I will highlight my first can layer and I will move it, just like that. Definitely I will bring size down for this layer and I will move it and I will increase size. Perfect. I will click OK to to accept this layer as well. So guys, now I have three layers with three cans of my soda. What I will do? I will hide my top layer, my front soda can, and I will hide my background layer and I will merge all visible layers. Just like that. And I will bring back my first can and my background layer as well. I have highlighted my two cans soda layer. I will go to filter, blur. You can use any blur filter you are more comfortable with. I will apply radius to my blur about probably, about 0.8. I will click OK. And now, guys, I created depth of field. So right now I have my first can in focus and two other cans just somewhere on background. And I can merge my all soda cans layers together. Merge down. And voila. So now I have two layers. One soda cans layer and another background layer. I will move my soda can layer in the middle. Just like that. And I will select my background layer. What I will do? It's very simple, guys. I will click on eyedropper tool. I will click on somewhere in my soda can. Basically, I'm choosing color out of my soda can. I will switch to my curvature pen tool. And in my options bar, I specify shape instead of path. And also I specify the color for my shape, and I don't need a stroke, so I will uncheck my stroke color and I will click one, two, three, and four. So what I will do, I will click and hold option key and I will click on my first curvature pen tool anchor point, just like that. Second, third, and voila. So guys, now I basically have created very beautiful, very elegant background, something very new and catch eyes catching effect. I applied catch ice catching effect to my background layer and I love it a lot. So what I will do, I will select my can layer. I will click on adjustment. I will click on exposure, and here in my properties panel I will click on add clipping mask, and now I will apply my adjustment layer only to my layer under my adjustment layer. So I will apply my adjustment layer only to my soda cans layer. I will bring down exposure just like that. I will move gamma correction slider slightly to the right, and voila, we are ready, guys. So we have created very beautiful image for commercial advertisement in Adobe Photoshop CC. We didn't go anywhere. We didn't shoot anything. We used only 3D objects I downloaded from pixelsquid.com, and we have created very beautiful image for a commercial advertisement. So guys, I hope you like this tutorial. If so, please subscribe to my channel, share my video, and I will see you soon. Thank you, guys. Bye.